In this overview, we'll walk through our growth investing model, which is based on the methodology outlined by Martin Zweig in his book, Winning on Wall Street. The key fundamental investing insight of this strategy is this. Growth investing can be challenging since expectations can exceed reality for many growth-like firms and their stocks. But by looking for companies that show earnings growth, stability, and persistency over time, that also have reasonable valuations and low debt, investors can identify stocks with a good chance that can continue to perform well in the future. At a high level, the strategy looks for stocks with strong and consistent earnings growth, both in the short term and the long term, that is also supported by comparable sales growth. It also filters for stocks with low debt, insider buying, and reasonable valuations. The source and the evidence behind the strategy, as I mentioned, this is sourced from the book Winning on Wall Street. At one point, Martin Zweig had the number one rated newsletter according to the Holbert Financial Digest, which was a company that tracked newsletter performance. Zweig's newsletter had the best risk-adjusted performance over the long term at one point in time. The investment thesis behind the strategy is this. Growth firms that are growing both earnings and sales rapidly and consistently can make excellent investments if that growth is accompanied by a reasonable stock price, a high conviction in insider buying, and low operating leverage. So now, let's take a look at the details behind the growth investing model run on Validia. This is based on the growth stock selection method outlined by Martin Zweig in Winning on Wall Street. Zweig first started out with a pretty wide valuation screen. He didn't want stocks that were too expensive or stocks with rock bottom valuations, which could signal deep problems for the company. So to start, the model screens out stocks that are trading at 3x the valuation of the market, so it removes the most expensive stocks, and it also removes the stocks with PEs below 5, or the very cheapest stocks, which could have permanent problems. The model also wants to see sales and top line growth. To that end, it looks at 1, revenue growth, which can't be substantially less than earnings growth, and 2, quarter over quarter sales growth must also be increasing. The next part is really the core of the strategy. In this earnings part, Zweig wanted to look at earnings through multiple angles and not just earnings-related growth metrics. He wanted to determine a company's stability in the trend in earnings persistence, and earnings acceleration potential. To determine a company's stability in the trend of earnings, Zweig looked at things such as the most recent quarterly earnings, whether or not they were positive, quarterly earnings 1 year ago, and whether or not those were positive, and also the growth in earnings year over year, which he also wanted to be a positive. For earnings persistence, Zweig wanted steady earnings growth over the long term. To pass this test, a company must grow earnings in each year over the past 5 years. The model also likes to see earnings growth more recently. And to handle this, the model looks at quarterly earnings growth in each quarter on a trailing 12-month basis to the same quarter a year ago. This ensures that recent growth is acceptable. And the last test in earnings persistence is the long-term growth in earnings, and the model rewards companies with at least a 15% annualized growth rate. Zweig finished his earnings gauntlet by looking at earnings acceleration. Here, he wanted strong historical earnings growth in the most recent quarter versus previous quarters and compared to the long-term historical growth rate. These two measures helped give Zweig confidence that earnings were in fact accelerating. From there, the model goes on to look at the total debt-to-equity ratio, allowing those stocks with debt-to-equity ratios below their industry average to pass the test. And lastly, Zweig wanted to see insiders buying and no one was selling. This was optimal in his mind. Extrapolating past growth in earnings into the future is one of the most difficult things for an investor to do. But our Zweig growth investor model presents a unique way to look at earnings and other factors in an effort to find good growth stocks worthy of consideration.